With a shutdown now inevitable, there are fears hundreds of businesses and tens of thousands of jobs could be lost. The Morrison government has offered a lifeline, desperately trying to build a floor under owners and employees in an attempt to avoid what could become the worst economic crash since the Great Depression.
Building a multi-billion dollar safety net to try and catch thousands.
What we'll be doing, as I said, is focusing on those in the front line, those who will be feeling the first blows of the economic impacts.
The amounts being racked up on the national credit card are breathtaking.
$66 billion to cushion the blow to households as a result of the coronavirus.
Money is now no object because bankruptcies and mass unemployment loom as the devastating side effect from the radical therapy prescribed to stop a virus.
What we'll be doing, as I said, is focusing on those in the front line, those who will be feeling the first blows of the economic impacts.
That blow will fall first and hardest on casual workers and sole traders. So for at least 6 months, the job seeker allowance will double to $1,100 a fortnight. There will now be two cash payments of $750 sent to pensioners and welfare recipients to arrive on March 31 and July 13. Those in financial distress will be allowed to access $10,000 from their super fund this financial year and $10,000 in the next. The pile of government money grows with the fear that the shock from the worldwide shutdown will deliver a crushing recession.
We now expect the economic shock to be deeper, wider, and longer.
And that means it is essential to keep businesses on their feet. So a minimum of $20,000 and up to $100,000 in cash will be available tax-free to 720,000 businesses and not-for-profits to help them keep paying their nearly 8 million staff. The government will also go guarantor for 50% of unsecured business loans up to $250,000 to boost cash flow. The rescue plan also includes changes to bankruptcy laws.
It'll also provide a shield to protect you.
But this is just the beginning of a desperate bid to save the economy.
There will be more packages. There will be more support.
A stripped-down parliament will return tomorrow to pass this package into law.
We need economic stimulus to protect your job and your business right now, and that we will be supportive of these measures.
As words are now measured in the language of war.
The more we work together, the more we share the load, the more we share the sacrifice, the more we do the right thing together as Australians, the more lives we will save.
The lights are going out on businesses all over Australia. Some will never be relit.
Let's get analysis now from the Nine Network's political editor, Chris Yeoman. Chris, what can we expect from tonight's emergency cabinet meeting?
That the list of restrictions will grow, Pete, and leading the charge to go hardest to the two biggest states, New South Wales and Victoria, because they believe their people need to be shocked into understanding that the only way to slow this disease is to keep people apart. Australia is on a war footing. The state borders are closing for the first time in 100 years. Soon some suburbs and even cities might be completely locked down. So after a brutal summer, Australia now faces its bitterest winter since the Spanish flu killed at least 15,000 of us in 1919. Pete?
Sobering, Chris. Thank you. Reaction to the government stimulus package has been mixed, with business owners saying it won't be enough to keep them alive. Small, medium and large businesses, along with sole traders, are now trying to negotiate uncertain times, facing the prospect of having no income but having to pay ongoing costs.
A sunny Sunday Bondi lunchtime maybe, but it's a gloomy outlook for Fatos Varda. She runs a pizza bar and cafe side by side, taking double the hit when business dried up 3 weeks ago.
All gone. All gone.
She says the $20,000 grant offered by the federal government today won't cover the $30,000 she pays in rent each month, not to mention the $3,000 to council for outdoor tables and other costs that will continue even when her doors are closed.
What I do, me, I don't know. I like it, please help me, government, or who helped, somebody helped me to do electric, gas, or rent.
Pilates instructor Gaetano Delmonico already closed his popular studio 2 weeks ago, concerned about the health risk to his clients. As a sole trader with no employees, he's not eligible for any grants, only the job seeker payment and coronavirus supplement.
Well, I still have to pay my commercial rent. I have to pay outgoings. I have to pay my home loan. I've loss of income and all these bills. So it does nothing for me at all.
He believes rent relief and a deferral of BAS payments should have been included in the assistance package as a way to help sole traders survive. The North's Collective, which operates four clubs in Sydney, had already planned to close one, the Greens at North Sydney, for 5 months from tomorrow. It now faces shutting down all its clubs completely. With 170 permanent staff, North's had already made the difficult decision to cancel shifts for 210 casuals.
We do understand that it's more than just a club being open. This is certainly about people's lives and livelihoods.
Luke Simmons says while banks are being supportive, more help will be required from government if the industry is to survive.
We do understand that this is a public health challenge and we certainly respect that. We are looking to come out of the other side of this and make sure that we can help our suppliers and our supply chain get back on track with the help of our staff.
It's a whole class of workers right now who are simply in limbo. They've been stood down but they're still on the books. It means they're not earning an income but they're not technically unemployed.
And that could now be the case for retail workers with the doors to their stores about to be shut.
This industry employs almost 1 in 10 Australians. It is not an industry the government can turn its back on.
I can tell you we're scared, we're worried as retailers. We have a wonderful group of employees, of staff. We call them family members and we worry for them.
From unions to employers and staff, all are calling for their own dedicated relief package.
This would not only help me as my family, but all my teammates and members who are experiencing difficulties at this difficult time.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.